it's time for another doodle. And this time, first of all, excitingly, these doodles, one of them was featured in The Guardian. Isn't that nice? About comedians doing things to not go insane during lockdown. So that's very nice. And so maybe there'll be some new visitors. So that can be quite exciting. And now this is a commission. It is a commission. Hang on, let me just find out exactly the full name so I don't seem like a bum bum. No, the last thing we want is to be a bum bum. That would be terrible. Okay, commissions. Doopy doo. Robyn, that's right. I don't know if I should say a surname. I'll just leave it. But the description is totally up to you. That's what she wants. And so I'm going to try and do something a bit more realistic. It's been a long time since I did something realistic in any way, shape, or form. So we're going to be pencil boys and girls this time. And thank you to everyone who's been donating or buying things or whatever. It's been very, very generous. And well, not surprising. I have very good fans, but you never know. It's been very nice. So now that we've got a nice sharp HB pencil, let's get going, I suppose. Let's flipping get going. Now, this is quite a thing for me, because I am so, if I try to be realistic, I get so het up about the details that it's probably quite unhealthy. What I've got is a photo on my laptop up. I've got a photo up on my laptop. There we go. Why do I speak like a German sometimes? English is my first language. There's no reason for this to be the case. I've got a photo of Pope Francis blowing his nose. That was used to illustrate a news article. I thought the other day we were talking about the Renaissance, and I was trying to pretend to be a Renaissance boy. So why not go full Renaissance and do a drawing of the Pope? No one's ever done that before. That's his little Pope hat. Very roughly. There we go. Just put a little Pope ear was there. And there's another Pope ear. Probably here is the best starting point for the Pope ear. Big old men always have big ears, because your ear cartilage keeps growing, apparently. So hopefully I will be lucky enough to be an old man, and then I can have big ears too. Big characterful ears, that's what I want from my old age. It will be a hard to remember line later, so let's just make it less prominent. Those. Okay. Yes. Okay, that's looking pretty good. This big old Pope shoulder kind of starts here. I'll post the image I'm doing this from, maybe on my Instagram at Pierre Novelli, or my Twitter at Pierre Novelli. Good luck spelling that. So that you can judge for yourself how good I am, or not. So it goes down from there, and the angle is not quite so steep, actually. That's better. Okay. Now the collar here goes from next to his eye. Kind of zoomed in on this a bit. These proportions are not quite right. How much have I zoomed in? I should try and zoom in the equivalent amount on my drawing. In which case, this needs to be redrawn. You see, already we're fiddling and faffing. We don't have time, crucially. I don't want to make these the world's largest video files. That's not my intention here, people. So we don't necessarily have time to faff. And that's a good thing. The more time you give yourself to faff, the longer this sort of thing takes, the more crazy you go about the details and the fiddling. And it's better to just get on with it, for heaven's sake. I used to do caricatures, so I should be better at speed drawing than I thought, but that's muscle memory, you know. You remember it, you don't forget at all, but you do forget. You do forget these things. Right, okay, let's get serious here. We've got his lovely hat, that's pretty much there. I wonder what it's called. A capula or something. I bet it's got to be in Latin, doesn't it? That's classic poping. Let me go and try and keep that sharp line there. There we go. Bit of hair coming down here to his poop ear. It's the technical term. Sometimes it's useful to focus on something like an ear to give your drawing almost an anchoring point, because then you go, well, if that's the ear, then this has to be like this. So it's sort of like putting a jigsaw puzzle together of your own making. If I was really good, right, a really good boy and smart, what I would do is I would have done a sort of grid. I would have done a grid all around the Pope. And it would have been something like a mesh net almost over this guy. This guy here, and it means that you can do everything in proportion. So if I've been very clever indeed, that's the sort of thing I would have done. Kind of his hair there. Where does his hair start here? Kind of here, all on the sides. And then I don't know if I'll keep this. Sometimes I rebel against the idea of keeping something like this in pencil. And I decide to go over it in pen. We'll see if we have time for me to even think in such ridiculous and reckless ways. It's not looking too bad. This is for all the haters out there who think that I can't do real art like a human, instead of the grotesque monsters I insist on forcing into your line of vision daily. Now this one goes beyond the snot rag. Mm-hmm. He's a bit jollier than I gave him credit for, you know. But he's an old fella. I'm not a religious fella. In case you're wondering, that's why I picked him. It's very much the Renaissance connection. Just get some eyebrow outlines in here. His brows are on point. Yes, Queen. Is that right? Am I good? Am I on board? Is that the kind of thing people want to hear? While they watch a comedian sketch the Pope? Sassiness. Is this really the time for sassiness? Oh, he looks furious there. Looks like an X-Men villain. That won't do. We've got the angles all wrong on them brows. They are not Yes Queen. It's got to be flatter at the base. That's why we've got him doing an evil brow. There we go. Instead of the holy and humble brow that a holy man would have, I'm sure. I wonder if I've ever met a holy man. I wonder if I've ever thought to myself, you know what, you know that guy who I just met? I can't help but get from him some very holy vibes. Maybe it's like Gaydar. Hang on a minute. Either I'm crazy, or this guy's holy. I think, hang on a second, I think this guy might be holy. I better ask some of my holy friends. They'll know, they all know. Old bag eyes, there we go. His eye bags kind of go out like that a bit. We're not going to get the angles exactly right here, everyone. Nor should we expect to. And remember, the area... of colour in an eye. Basically never, you never see the full circle. He's kind of looking down more than he's doing that. And there's maybe a bit of a ridge here that I've missed out. Slightly off to the side, maybe. I'm being fiddly. You guys can't even see what I'm seeing. What am I doing? Who am I trying to impress? You never see the... what have I done here? You never see the full roundness of the iris unless someone's really widening their eyes at you. But some people I have noticed in my life and in my travels, they have eyes that naturally show you their whole... their whole iris. And they are very sort of Rasputin-y figures, I think. Because your eye is kind of not supposed to do that. But there they are with their big old eyes pointing at you. And those are the eyes I think about when I think about the slightly... everyone's favorite, now in hindsight, slightly tedious sitcom, How I Met Your Mother. Not to throw shade or anything. There's an episode where he, what's his name, Ted, goes out with someone who they all call Crazy Eyes because she has the crazy eyes. This guy's got some pretty crazy eyes right now. Those angles aren't quite right, although they're a bit flat. She has crazy eyes, but they never show you what they look like. They're like CGI in these like big spirals. And that's what they say the crazy eyes are. And I always assume they mean those eyes. I don't know how they CGI'd in spirals. Was she wearing, like, green screen contact lenses? I've just thought of that. Big green eyes. Terrifying. Okay, Poopy. Oh, I got some... skin kind of shuts other skin down in an interesting way. These wrinkles. Let me just zoom in a bit. Adjust the... Yeah, there we go. It's a bit more shadow than I was bargaining for. Darker than I thought. Okay, that's there. I got a better... What interesting brows you have, Grandma. Mm-hmm. And his forehead wrinkles. I've made his forehead way too small. Dear me. Yeah, he's got a much bigger forehead than that. How do we fix that? It's hard to say. I can't believe I'm about to say this, everyone, but we're going to have to readjust the Pope hat. Hats on last, maybe, should be our rule. Hats on last. Okay, they should be about here, in fact. I'm using the bits of his ear, say, and I'm looking at the image and using it to measure. Now, you know, in cartoons, I always thought this was weird when I was a kid. Artists are always holding up their thumb and squinting while they're doing paintings. Swish, swish, swish. That's to get scale. So you measure it in thumbnails. Like, oh, that's 3 thumbnails, so that should be like this. I never knew that until I was already a man. And I looked it up. I Googled it. Steep old hat, this actually. Didn't give the old fella credit for having such a steep old hat. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay. And then we've got a bit more. He's not bald, is he? He's got hair. He's a sort of vaguely hairy guy. Is that sacrilegious? To accuse the Pope of having vague hair? He's got all sorts of fun forehead lines that I will be too lazy to do properly. He said truthfully and honestly. Right. And... Oh, that line's a lot stronger than I thought, actually. Really comes right out of there. Right, so now the tissue. There's a vague point in the tissue here. That's what always impressed me about what you might call proper artists so much, is their ability to draw fabric. Great swirly fabric with depth and volume. And it's the kind of thing that when you're a kid and you look at art, as much as it's good to look at art and be impressed by it, it can be unbelievably demoralizing to look at these works of just pure beauty and genius. And then your teacher says, right, draw your shoe, everyone. And you think, God, why bother? Why bother? I'll never be a genius like these geniuses, what am I doing? And the answer is, because you might be, and also for fun. And it is part of the human condition. It's like saying you'd never want to play football again because you'll never be. And here I come to my limit of sporting knowledge. Ronaldo, he's good. Bit of a straighter line than that, actually. There's Charlie Jowls. Go up like that. Yes. Okay. Now, the hard part, the really hard part. This is very rough. I say realistic. I mean, we're let's not pretend that we're going to absolutely nail this, because we aren't. We don't have time. I don't think these should really be ever that much longer than an hour. I know I've broken that rule. But you simply have to forgive me, because I genuinely lost track of time. That's how much I enjoy doing these videos for you. A doobie-doo. Right. Okay, yeah, that's roughly the shape. That's not quite what it does, but let's just say it is for now. Okay, that should actually be a bit bigger. That's alright, we can fix that later. It's important to know what to prioritize. Sometimes you'll end up... I remember at school when you would have only a lesson or whatever to do something like this, and you would end up this perfectly shaded ear, and you'd just done outlines for the rest of them because you'd got lost in the ear, fiddling. You've always got to try and keep it a bit swift. There we go. Okay, swift, swift, swift. These are big claims, Novelli, about swiftness that you're making. But can you put your money where your mouth is, as it were? That's kind of a finger here, too. Okay. But how long are these man's fingers? They're pretty long. You'll just have to believe me that they are. Now these lines are getting in the way, so let's get rid of them. We want vertical lines. None of these filthy horizontals you've heard so much about in the news. Bum, bum, bum. Is that right? No, that's not quite right. It's amazing how lazy the human eye is. And I say lazy when I really should say efficient, because your eye makes big assumptions all the time. You very rarely look at something properly. Your eye will go, yeah, yeah, that's grass. We don't need to look at all the grass. We're busy keeping an eye out for predators and ice cream trucks. But in reality, when you're trying to draw something accurately, you're really going to have to look at everything individually in of itself. And it's very tiring. And your eyes go, what are we focusing on here? What is this? What's going on out there? To be able to shush that part of your brain long enough to do a realistic Pope drawing. That old chestnut. It's got a kind of knobbly finger. I think everyone ends up with knobbly fingers. Even if you have big fat fingers, you're probably going to end up with some knobbling. But there's nothing wrong with some light knobbling. Quite vampiric, these fingers, aren't they? Yeah, it's not really inappropriately so for a pope, I would say. Let's try and make them a bit more circular and fun. Round objects always seem less threatening than jagged ones. And he's got a big, beautiful pope ring. Right there, and it's kind of more of an oval. And he's got a very nice sort of almost serifed cross. It's not quite bang on, is it? Yeah, I think sometimes I would like a rubber, an eraser, that is sort of almost like as sharp as a pencil, you know. That's the kind of thing I dream of. There we are. Okay, now then. Old Knuckles McPope over here. God, imagine if poor old Robyn, who commissioned this, hates the Pope, and I'm forcing this whole Pope thing right into her home, possibly, if I can post this. Should sign it and post it. That's what a commission is, I guess. Maybe she'll be like, you know what? The video was enough. I don't need the Pope in my house blowing his nose. Okay, down here. How far down after this do we get this? Pretty far down, actually. Get rid of this handkerchief line here, it's confusing our eyes. Okay. Goes in like that, and then kind of broadly straight down in a sweep to about here. This is actually the bottom of the image. So we're just going to assume that I haven't completely misscaled this. Just let it continue on its way. Just a little further down. This will be a bugger if I don't do this now. Is bugger a swear word? I wouldn't say so. Honestly. I wouldn't say so. But maybe I'm wrong. I've been wrong before. And I'll be wrong again. Regardless, it looks like a pretty high quality hanky. So we must show it the respect it is due as the Pope's hanky. Which would be quite a good sort of swear word or exclamation by the handkerchief of the Pope. It's the sort of thing you'd say to be almost blasphemous, but not quite, as a medieval knight. Like that would the king would go, ooh. Sir Percy. You're risking it all here with that kind of talk. You're towing the line, but barely. We've all got our eye on you. You start doubting transubstantiation or talking about the Fratelli heresy again. Fratelli? No, that's the bad. That's the bad. The Fratellis. Fraticelli. I'm sure you were all yelling that at the screen. How do you know about the Fraticelli heresy, Pierre? Are you a learned scholar, or do you just play video games like Crusader Kings 2? Let's say that I'm a learned scholar. Let's ignore the fact that an enormous proportion of my knowledge comes from silly video games. And to be fair to myself, compulsively looking up what the video game is talking about out of frustration when I lose the game. They rebelled over what? That's me. Playing Crusader Kings. Where does that sweep come in? Basically at the same place. You see your lazy eye, Pierre, making these big assumptions, letting yourself off the hook for detail's sake. Okay. That's the one thing that this mode of drawing does always take is time. I've done something a bit funny from my usual diet of splashing ink around the place and drawing something horrible. So, bear with me while I struggle to find my way in this new world, or rather, rediscover it. This guy does something pretty similar. And then we find our old friend, the index finger. Over here. Should I try and get these subtitled? Maybe. That would be an inclusive thing to do. I've always wanted to get my comedy shows signed, but it's so expensive. I should look into charities or something. Maybe I'll get funding that way. Or maybe I should just take the hit, I don't know. I hope you're finding this relaxing, by the way. Some people have said so on Twitter, that they find it soothing. It's certainly an angle, isn't it? For a comedian. I may or may not make you laugh, but by God, you'll be soothed. Soothed within an inch of your life. Now, this is some of his decorated collar that we're looking at here. So, firstly, slightly over. And, oh, that goes all the way down. I've underestimated the size of his, what is it called? Big religion scarf. Don't flaunt your ignorance, Pierre. It's unbecoming. Sometimes quite a funny thing happens with a, not too much pressure on the word funny, admittedly, but you find yourself adding in things that aren't really there to try and make it, as it were, more realistic looking, things that aren't in the photo. You find yourself doing a bit of fiddling like that. This goes further down into a kind of knuckle shadow. Often things you're going to shade, you can represent with kind of a scribbly-do for later fixing. That can save you a bit of the old precious time and everything. This goes quite far down here. That's fine as far as things go. Yeah. face here. There's a bit of a line that comes here. And then it keeps going. Yeah, well, this goes quite curvy, actually. Now let's make sure we know what's what down there. Okay. That's quite a dark bit of shadow around here. Only bright white and a kind of line there, which means that these lines are the exact opposite of the sort of thing we'd like to see. Mm-hmm. And this also has some shading lines that we should honor. I have to admit, the idea for doing this in pencil came because me and my flatmate rewatched Silence of the Lambs last night. And I know it's not what you're supposed to take from Hannibal Lecter, but I can't help but be continually impressed by the quality of that particular psychopathic murderer's pencil sketches of various sites of great historical interest and architectural beauty, mostly in Florence. He seems sort of obsessed with Florence. And the fact that he sits in his little room and draws Florence all the time means that you would think he would have figured out where he ran to a bit sooner. Oh, I wonder where he's gone. Maybe he's gone to Reno. Well, I don't think so. Have you thought about Florence, given that he just sat and rambled about Florence in his little jumpsuit? Good old Anthony Hopkins, absolutely nailing it. You know what I would say about Mads Mikkelsen's Hannibal Lecter? He's the Instagram Hannibal Lecter. It's all show. It's all aesthetics and being a very, very handsome man, like a model. The thing about being right-handed is that you'll always draw things kind of squinting off to the right-hand side a little bit. Which is a shame, but there's nothing to be done. There's nothing to be done. Alright, now this bit's gonna be tough. Slight dip there. Into some sort of circle thing here. Maybe I can inset the image I'm doing this from and you can judge for yourself. Or maybe I just make you accept that what I'm doing is just fine. This isn't about the challenge anyway. Or proving oneself. It's about just enjoying doing a bit of art for the goodness sake. Which is hard enough to do in the usual stressful lives we all live. Never mind now. So, I sneezed in one of the videos the other day and someone commented that they said, "Bless you." Well, bless you. Now that we're drawing the Pope, okay, and then there's a kind of a loop-de-loo here. first art teacher, Miss Gullen, be pleased that I'm back again drawing religious figures with lots of folds in their clothes. She was always very keen on us drawing sort of angels. If you are watching this because you like ASMR, I can recommend something to you guys, which is a very, very funny comedian who I'm friends with and who I like a lot, Jack Barry. Jack Barry did an ASMR stand-up special, which I think I'll link to it at the end of this video. I'll figure out how to do that. And it's really funny. I mean, he's very, very funny, but he's also done it like whispering, like it's ASMR. So I would recommend that if you're into ASMR, because presumably it qualifies for all of your favorite things. Now, there's some kind of symbol pin thing here. More of an angle than that, Pierre. Focus, boy, focus. That's what my rugby coach used to say. Focus, boy. Because I was not focused, and I could not catch. But I was a giant child, so I could run at people and smush them. Like the giant boy I was. Slight shadow of it. And then at the point of shadow it goes across. Okay. So disappear there. And it's a chrismon, I think. It's a classic chrismon. The symbol of Christ. Or a symbol of Christ. There are so many. If you do a degree in early medieval history like I did, you will see that there are so many symbols of Christ that they will start to drive you slightly insane as you struggle to remember them all. Right, okay, how are we doing for time? We're doing just fine for time. There's no need to be a timekeeping worrying person. There's something sticking out there. I don't know what that is, but fine. No, it goes out much further than that. Get real. Get real, boy. Something there. Dirt. Okay, now this is a lot of folds. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Right. So, we've got a lot of darkness. Actually goes down there. Fiddles. Okay. And this can go here. Yeah. got ourselves a pope. Now it's time to sort out the forehead that we were being too lazy to do properly earlier. They really are just like lines in his skin, he said, asininely describing exactly what we already know forehead wrinkles are. He's a bit shiny in this as well, he's a bit sweaty. Does look a bit ill, let's hope he's not ill. Doing those shiny lines as if I'm going to have time and the ability to do them. Right. We're pretty much there, I think. Horrifyingly, in a way. Now there's no choice but to get shading, dear me, and we only really have a bit of time. Now this is the big question. Keep it in pencil or become a naughty pen boy? I think keep it in pencil. What's this guy? A 5B, that's nice and soft. We could use a man like a 5B around here. Or should we do more definite lines first? We'll do this first. What do we know is very dark? We know the eyes are very dark. So let's do some of those. Dark as we can. Dark as we can get away with. Very dark indeed in this photo. They're not really coming through as their own thing. And he's got some dark old eyebrows. Okay. Yeah. That's quite dark. Are also quite dark. Getting a bit scrappy, but that's nice. We can do that. We can get away with that. Hopefully Robyn won't mind. Bit of scrappy old pope shading. Well, just like the old days. Just like the good old days, remember? When the pope shading was all scrappy. But there's no need to have such scribbling lines, Pierre. It's your lack of self-discipline coming through, boy. Now this is very dark as well, this chrismon business. Should be as dark can be. barely visible, but we're going to suggest them by drawing in the hell out of them and then shading over them to obscure them. So they look subtle, even though they're starting out as absolutely brutal. Aren't we clever? Sort of. Sometimes we're clever. Oh, that actually goes to a point. What have I done that for? I haven't got that quite right. Oh dear, he said. There will be mistakes. There will be casualties. In the great art war. Be a lot of smudging, ladies and gentlemen. So we should start doing lots of blowing, which may be good or bad for ASMR. I don't know. I don't know enough about it. Okay. Right. Quick bit of redraftsmanship here. He's got his big old jaw there. That needs to be actually becoming a corner point. Yes, just about. Why am I being lazy? I am. Always trying to save time. That's better. Right. As we were. Can be happy with that. That needs to be dark. There we go. That makes it look nice in 3D, doesn't it? License here. Do forgive me, Mr. Pope. Is that still sharp enough? Not for our line purposes. Okay, that's sharp. Look at that. Oh dear. Okay. Slightly too sharp. To do the other eyeball. Yeah. Oh, jeez. Calm down there, Novelli. Can't be snapping pencils like that. People are gonna, the neighbors are gonna complain. Yep, that's really gone. lost ourselves our shading pencil. Maybe. There's every chance we have, you know. Ooh. No. Need some dark lines, for heaven's sake. Okay. That's nice and vague, so I'm going to do it for some vague shading. Our favorite kind, you and I. That should be... And there's a certain point where you have to accept that the lines you've drawn, accurate or inaccurate, are simply the lines that you have. There we go. Don't have time to be too diplomatic about getting a nice smooth outlines here. He said, savagely ignoring his own guidelines. I always found, when I was young and I was trying to do this sort of thing, that I could never produce enough variation in the shades of grey to describe what I was seeing. And you ended up with what should almost be black on cloth, being the same shade of grey as something that's sort of mid-ranged shade on a face. That always irritated me, that I couldn't produce this. What I viewed as absolutely crucial variation in things. That's what we should do, get some actual solid curving lines in here. Make it seem more organic and less scrap. Literally more rounded. Okay. Make sure there's some color everywhere, because there's no bright spots on the cloth. at all. Not one bright spot. And let's use our dirty pinky. Try and smudge it around. There we go. Soften some of this madness that we've imposed. It's all looking a bit too definite, isn't it? I need some more shade. I sort of wish I'd done ink. It would have been a lot easier. Right, now let's see how quickly we can do this boy. Need to sharpen this, that's for sure. Oh, broken again. Oh, that old familiar feeling. Let's switch to a 6B. Let's get real dark. Real dark. Okay. Oh, I can feel it wiggling. Actually, if we use a broken one, we can get some real shade happening. There we go. Ooh, come here. Takes a bit of dexterity, but if you can do it, the results will blow your mind. And now we need to re-darken these bits by quite a bit, don't we? Something like this should almost really call for charcoal, I think. It would be fair to say. Going back here. What are we doing now? We're losing track of who we are. Very scrappy, very scrappy. Made a rod for your own back here in the valley. And these fingers will be too smudgy. Certainly gone over time, that much I can tell you. Right. No, another broken one. This is quickly becoming the pencil sharpener channel. And I'm as confused as you are. This is what happens if you mistreat your tools and bang them around in your bags and things for ages, which is what I've been doing to them, I'm afraid. I'll admit that to you now. Perhaps it's time to go back to our old friend, HB. Thing is, I think... I'm pretty sure the softer ones, which are the ones we use for this crazy shading, are... the ones that break the most easily. As in art, as in life. You see. So let's just quickly try and get on with some of these lines. So we can say that we've done them. There we go, this is better. It's almost as though that's what you should have done from the start, Pierre, you silly goose. Yes, well, perhaps. But hindsight is the current year, 2020. I'm smudging my hand all over the place. Eventually, when you need to spray fixative on this, and you will, in order to keep all its constituent parts, behaving, as it were. It sounds a bit cheeky, but it's true. Hairspray will do. Our old friend Garden Variety Hairspray will do the trick. Just as well, in my experiences. Expensive, specially manufactured fixative. Now, if you want to be proper, then just use proper stuff. But man, art supplies are expensive. Especially if you keep breaking them here. There we go, that's alright. There we are. Nice, that turned out okay. No one needs to be embarrassed or ashamed about that, I would say. Okay. A little bit of this. pause this so I can wash my hands. 1 second. Okay, we are back and we are finishing up this wonderful little pope. I'm being lazy with my assumptions again. There we go. There we go. Let's try and get this done, lads, done. Okay. Hair is always the worst, honestly. I tell you, hair is always the worst. Get its joy in here. A bit of that line there. It's pretty defined. We get to the bit where I'm being a little riffy. Just a little riffy here. That's okay. And we must do our best to make sure that people don't think that the Pope's face is as white as a sheet. For example, the sheet that he is clearly blowing his nose on. There we go, that's a bit better. I've also been quite cheeky, by the way, guys, in case you're thinking, wow, he knows all the how black and white everything is supposed to be. I have been quite cheeky. And what I've done is I have turned the photo I'm doing this from into black and white. Oh, using Photoshop magic. So as to further help me see what's what regarding what exactly should be grey or shouldn't be. And that's a nice sneaky little trick you can do at home with any, I think any free Photoshop can do it. I'm using a free one. A reliable free one. Don't just download a load of malware because you want to draw the Pope. That's the last thing the Pope would want. You would hate to think that you downloaded malware just to try and physically represent his form here on Earth. I'm saying that like he's supposed to have a different form in heaven. I don't think so, particularly. No more than the rest of us. My theology is very weak, though. I'll admit that much to you. Okie dokie. Pig in a pokey, job seekers. I recommend rewatching The League of Gentlemen. It's brilliant. I mean, obviously, you know that. In the sense that we know this sort of thing to be true, but it really is amazing. Shading here, we're getting a little scratchy, almost like cross hatching, but not quite. Just for bits of extra shadow, like this bit here in the image has got a bit of extra shadow to it. The bits next to the cloth are slightly darker, slightly darker. Doing little bits of black and white. So people don't think our art is bad. I wonder how many people in Italy like the Pope. I mean, I know loads of them sort of like him officially, as it were, but they must have all sorts of opinions on him. They must have all sorts of varying degrees of feeling and regard for him. I can only imagine. Because I'm too lazy to go and ask everyone in Italy how they feel about the Pope, and I think that's a forgivable character flaw. Right. This is some more darkness here. Some smudgy McSmudgington over here. important to try and accept the things that we cannot change, is it not? It's not nearly dark enough. Oh, 6B, 5B, where are you? Now that we need you, do you slumber neath a barrow until the hour of England's greatest need, like King Arthur? Or are you here, trapped in this broken pencil? Yes, that pencil is so thoroughly broken. Oh dear. I don't know if you knew this, but the reason that they put wood around the lead is because it makes it a lot easier to draw with. Drawing without it is, I have to tell you, as I'm doing it now, a massive faff. And you know how I feel about faff. Life has enough faff in it. Is there any need to go around adding in even more? I wouldn't have said so myself. No. Now this is also supposed to be dark. Well, it certainly looks like the Pope, I would say, given that he's wearing a Pope hat, it's kind of cheating. Someone said, who's that? And they go, well, judging by the Christian ring and the Pope hat, we're dealing with the Pope over here. Certainly, it would be a very bad disguise for the Pope to wear. Pope hat. That we can agree on. We may not agree on everything, you and I, but we can agree that this would be a very weak disguise game from the Pope. Let's try and keep this civil. That's not all dark there, annoyingly. I've kind of screwed that up. Oh well. Oh well. No survivors sometimes. Says with faux decisiveness. Okay. Hey, do you remember how I went to go wash my hands? That went well. How decisive was that? Smudge this guy right up. Yeah, come here, little thing. Make this a bit darker too. Looking nice and velvety. There we go. That's better. We can clean that up in a bit. Too unhappy with that. I wouldn't say I'm beaming. I'm not too unhappy with that at all. And this is another sharp line that we're expected to do. It's his face. And that bit of Pope face there is actually quite dark. Because of the old shadows. It's good old light again, isn't it? Playing tricks on us and creating shadows. where they may or may not normally be shadows. Now, if I was a real Renaissance artist, I would have left loads of clues for a Dan Brown novel in this. But I haven't done that, so I can't be a real Renaissance artist. Now, we're just going to dirty up the old Pope face here to make sure no one thinks that we're claiming that his face is supposed to be as white as the hat, the handkerchief, or the religion scarf, whose name I can't remember. There we go. It's a bit of shade in there. Never be afraid to just get in there with your fingers and create some reality the way you think it should look. Is that a sort of motto? Could be. Could be. People are very loose about things like mottos qualifying for being mottos these days. Very loose indeed. You'll notice we've lost some of his shininess of forehead that I mentioned earlier. Well, that, my friends, is what erasers are for. Now that we've smudged him, we can use the eraser to create wonderful highlights. Let's try and smudge these hands a bit as well. There we go. He's looking pretty. He's looking, if I may say so, popier by the second. There we are. Look at him go. It's only bloody Il Papa. Is that right? I don't know. Yeah. Yes. Right now. Time for a bit of surgery from the old eraser, rubber eraser. There we go, keep those lines sharp. I'm gonna try and hold this down. Sweat patches. Look at that, there we are, that's nice. And then we'll make sure that this is as white as can be. Erase some of these lines here. It doesn't look quite so defined anymore. And then all the way down here, get it nice and clear so people can see the difference between cloth and hand a bit more clearly. What else needs a bit of highlight? That needs a bit of highlight. shadow thing there. Trust me that that's just my own poor personal arrangement. And that there is to be no shadow there. 3B... HB... 3B... There's a little bit of shadow here, and then we want to make sure that this lovely stole, or whatever it's called, I can't remember the name for the life of me, is bright white. No messing about at all. Get some old tissue here. Grubby fingerprints, that's something you don't hear a lot about in art. I wonder if Da Vinci left any of his fingerprints on his wonderful pieces that were almost as incredible as this Pope that we've doodled. Maybe this can be promoted from doodle to full drawing. God, imagine the... So, high ranking. This needs to be a bit darker. Maybe not that much darker. Let's see. Yes. We've certainly done something. There's someone... said something about the title of my sex tape in one of the comments. Well, that's certainly something, isn't it? Which is an amusing title. And a good old indirect Brooklyn Nine-Nine reference that we can all enjoy. Okay, now, once this video is done, I'm going to spray this sweet mother. Oh god, no. Fingerprints, oh no. With fixative. Because as much as I talked a big game about hairspray, I do actually still have a tin of fixative left over from Lord knows when I was trying to pretend I was going to do more art. Which I seem to spend my whole life saying, well, now I'll finally have time to do some art. And then I don't do it. Well, now that there's a global plague, put some shadow in the background. We want to emphasize the holy purity of the whiteness of what he is wearing. With some of our own grubby reality here in the background. Yeah, pretty happy. through the camera here. Well, it's certainly the Pope. I don't think anyone can take that away from us. Eyes need to be darker. In the photo, you basically can't make out his pupil. I've just sort of pretended that you can, really. Apologies if you can hear that slightly annoying noise. I live with a robot. I don't. I live above a place that has shutters. And they do love to whir their shutters. I will say that for them. As ever, the old chestnut, everyone, when do we stop fiddling and just accept what we've done, for goodness sake? And to be fair, the cross should be shiny. It's reflecting a lot of light in the photo, what was being made of presumably gold. Fingernails are shiny, but they're not that shiny, so let's blur them up a bit. There we are. Okay, now. You would think that the thing I live above would be shut during these terrible times, but it isn't, because it is an NHS building that has shutters. And God bless those noisy buggers. Mm-hmm. I sure do love their worry. Well, that's it for today. Let's sign it. What will my art signature be? Let's invent it together, shall we? We'll do... From now on, this is my art signature. Actually, I'll sign it off camera. Ha! Take that, fraudsters. Trying to make at least £3 from this work. Yeah, that's it. That's the Pope. I hope you enjoyed the Pope. Bye.